Yo, what's up? I'm Martha from Galaxy Cube, and I have some cool things to show you today. I was just creating some demos for a presentation that I'm gonna have, had some location data, and I realized I'm gonna pull that data into one of the map visuals in Power BI. Fine. So I pull up Azure Data Map. Do you know that there is some new things? I didn't, okay? So there's just all these different types of layers you can use. You can pull in traffic data. There's 3D features. But you know what? Enough of all this talking. You know what I like to do? Let me show you. Let's head over to my laptop. Alrighty. So I pulled in some data on city bikes in Oslo. And I also pulled in some weather data. And I created a little nice star schema for us. And as I already told you, I have some location information in my data. So I have some longitude and latitude stuff. So let's just pull up Azure Data Map. So I do say like Azure Data Map throughout this entire recording. And sorry about that. It's actually called Azure Map. The visual is called Azure Map. This whole video is about Azure Map. So you see here, we can fill in different types of fields. So let's just start with the longitude and the latitude. And I need to tell it not to summarize. Boom. Okay, so we have some data. We have some points. So this is essentially showing us all the different bike stations that exists in Oslo. I'm from Norway, Oslo, if you didn't know. So this is like my area. We also see here that we have a size. So I'm going to pull in the number of rides for each station. And that's going to give us the size of the bubbles. I mean, that was maybe a bit messy. So let's take a look at format your visuals. What can we do here? Now, one thing that I see immediately is that I have activated the bubble layer. But I could have activated clustered bubbles. So now you see that in this area over here, for instance, we have 32 stations. And in the area over here, we have two. Cool. But let's stay with the bubble layer for now, because you can go in here and you can, of course, customize it. So I want to make this a little bit smaller. You know, the max doesn't need to be like crazy. Something like that. And you know what? I don't like the border. So just this go away border. Okay, cool. I feel like we cleaned it up a little bit. Now, other thing I could also pull in is the category labels. Now, that would be the longitude and latitude information. That doesn't make sense for us to use, so I'm not going to pull in that. But here we also have heat map. Ooh, look at that. That's also very cool. And then this, this one is very awesome. 3D layer. Oh my God. And I can zoom in and I can look at this and be like, oh wow, this one. A lot of rides going on here. You know, if you feel a bit fancy, this is definitely something you could look at. But let's not go too crazy now. Let's just go with this. Now, if I go up to map setting here, you see that there's a bunch of different things to make it easier to read or less easy to read. It depends. So I could really just clean it up a lot and remove like road details and so on. But obviously, I'm working with bike data. So the roads are going to be relevant. So I'm going to keep them in here. I'm going to remove labels to clean it up a bit. And then under controls here, you can also say what different types of controls can people see when they are playing around with this map. So for instance, should the navigation pane be here? I want it there. But I could also say that I want selection to be here as well. I'm going to come back to this one. This is cool. So now you're probably like, okay, that was cool. You have bubbles on the map. Why am I excited about this, Martha? Because there's more things you can do. Okay, so let's pull some insights out of this. You see here that we have path ID. So I do have a path ID that I can pull in. So I'm going to do that. Okay, so yes, this is maybe not that easy to read again. So let's go back to the format pane and see if we can clean this up a little bit. So if you go to the path layer, let's make the transparency a bit higher and also less wide. I agree, don't worry, it's still a bit messy. Let's pull in some more filters here because right now it's obviously showing way too many data points for this way to visualize this. So I want to pull in a filter on the actual station ID. Let's make that a drop down. And I also want one on the duration time. Now the duration here shows us how many minutes each trip is taking. Before we do anything, let's just clean it up even a little bit more. Beautiful. Now let's choose one of the stations. Now we see that we've filtered, and you can see that there's a bunch of different trips that's been happening between the 1st and 11th of May. And you have some that are pretty long here. That's impressive. Now, if we go back to the format layer here, we go into traffic layer, you see here that boom. Oh, wow. We can now suddenly get some traffic information. If I open up traffic control here, you can filter this directly here. And actually, this is like giving us some information about traffic, which roads are closed and so on. Okay, cool. But what else can we do? What if I want to figure out if, is it more time efficient to bike than to actually drive by car? So let's check that out. So let's, first of all, I'll just remove this for visibility now. So let's say that we only want to look at trips that took 10 minutes or less. Now what I can do here with selection is that I can go into range selection. I only want to see how far I can travel in 10 minutes if I start in this point. Let's click search. All right. Okay, so we see here that some of my trips here, the bike is going to be more efficient. We should choose the bike. Cool. Okay, so there's one more thing I want to show you. So again, let's go into the format pane here. A thing that we haven't looked at yet is the reference layer. And you see here that I can apparently load a file or an URL. Okay, let's just pull in an URL. Now, to be honest with you guys, I don't have a bunch of different URLs with data, but I did find one. So this layer is actually showing you not Oslo City, but the Oslo municipality. So obviously this might actually stay static. But now obviously you might have a different reference layer that is changing in time. And since you're pulling in an URL, you're always gonna have the updated data here in your visual. That's pretty cool. But for us, yeah, I know, that was maybe not the coolest example. So let me just load an actual file. So I have one that is telling us something about nature types in the city. Now, if I zoom in here, we see, for instance, that we have a little bit of a river flowing through here. Okay, that was cool, right? Now, obviously, you could pair the actual map visual with other visuals and just make it really interactive. For instance, here you can see that we have some temperature that is rising. Obviously, when it's warmer, people are more inclined to choose bikes. We also see that they're used mostly in the middle of the day and maybe when getting home from work. Okay, cool. We see that, for instance, this island over here is a very nice place in Oslo. So if you filter here on a Sunday, you see that the size of these bubbles increase. Well, if we filter on Tuesday, they're pretty small, so we don't have that many people riding over to this beautiful island on regular weekdays. Now there's more things coming, so it's going to be published to web support soon. Just stay tuned. And I also know if you Google Azure Maps, you're going to be like, wait, does this cost money? No. If you have a Power BI license, you can use Azure Maps. It's fine, but you also have to remember to enable Azure Maps in your Power BI service admin portal. Okay, so you guys, what do we think? Was this cool? Are you going to use it? Are you already using it? Any use cases I should check out that you want to tell me about? Let me know in the comments below. Remember to hit the subscribe button. Of course, to check out all the awesome videos from Adam, Patrick, and this girl. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!